Hey folks, Doug from blowback9.com here. Today let's talk about 9mm AR blowback bolts. Which ones I have, which ones I prefer, and why. And for that, I'm going to bring you in for a close-up of these bolts that I have sitting on the table here. Here are the 7 bolts I own. Starting from over here, we have Alpha Shooting Sports, Foxtrot Mike, FM9, TACCOM, Mercury Precision, Brownells, this is the hybrid, not the Glock only, hybrid bolt, Claw Valley Precision, and BK Firearms. Now, a few things you'll notice right away. This was my first bolt over here on the right. What we have here is a bolt where the bottom feed lug has been removed by a gunsmith for what they called a controlled feed improvement on the bolt. This, unfortunately, and I talk about this in another video, can result in an out of battery discharge pre-chambering, whereas the rest of the bolts all have a bottom feed lug, and that just by itself helps prevent out of battery discharges before the cartridge can be chambered. Generally, out of battery discharges happen as a result of bolt bounce after the cartridge has been chambered. But with this one, we can get an out of battery. If something stops the bolt pre-chambering just the right amount, it can actually fire the cartridge out of battery and cause a detonation, which is what happened to me. Now, a few things about why I prefer this type of bolt over here. First of all, you'll notice that the Alpha Shooting Sports has a 1911 style extractor. I have had nothing but problems with this type of extractor. It's also called an internal extractor because it's internal to the bolt as opposed to the rest, which are all external to the bolt. These are kind of finicky and tricky. If you start to lose tension in them, you have to pull them out and literally bend them into place, and it's trial and error. So I really don't like this type of bolt. This next one, the FM9, seems to be in general a good bolt. It has had some issues that potentially could come up regarding the firing pin spring being very light. Some folks have reported that they've experienced dented primers when chambering, especially when they use the Foxtrot Mike 308 spring, recoil spring that comes with the Foxtrot Mike kits, which I really don't like. I think it's a very bad idea putting extra power springs inside 9mm ARs. They're not necessary or beneficial. So because of the light spring in the firing pin and the heavy spring, 308 spring for the recoil spring, the forward momentum of the bolt and the firing pin seems to be able to overcome that light firing pin spring and actually dent primers. And in some cases, it's been reported they caused slam fires, which means when you slam the bolt home, it actually fires the cartridge. So not necessarily a good thing. Next one over is TACCOM. The TACCOM bolt is kind of special. This one is their short stroke bolt, and it's designed with an extra notch partway down the bolt on the underside, allowing it to catch the last round bolt hold open, or the bolt catch, when the bolt is not fully rearward. At least that's what it's supposed to do. In my test so far, I have had zero success with that in both Colt and Glock setups. I don't know if it's something I'm doing wrong, or something about the bolt, or something about my setups, but I cannot make this catch the last round bolt hold open, or the bolt catch, when it's short stroked. Next one over is the Mercury Precision. This one looked like it was a good contender, and even though the extractor is not a standard military style, the military mil-spec extractor, and it only has a spring built into it instead of the spring post and O-ring that's typical for a 5.56 extractor. It actually extracts and ejects perfectly. So have not had many problems with this, but there is one little difference that you'll notice between this bolt and the other three, my preferred three, and that is this little shelf right here sticks out quite a bit. And that can catch on the right-hand feed lip on Glock magazines and Glock lowers. In mine, it just barely skims across the lip and doesn't have any problems, so it doesn't catch, but if I push up on the magazine, it actually will catch and bind the bolt. So that's that right there, that tiny little protrusion. It's a groove, obviously, a cut that runs down the length of the underside of the bolt. That causes issues. And over here are my three preferred bolts and my preferred style of bolt. All of them are practically identical. You'll notice that that little groove is much smaller on these bolts, and therefore it does not seem to interfere with Glock magazines and Glock setups. They have external 5.56 mil-spec style extractors, and they have the spring post and O-ring built into those extractors. And these three, as well as this one, which is the one that kind of threw me off a little bit, but I've noticed a difference here, is that this has a flat top on the quote-unquote gas key. These all have curved tops. This style seems to be the one that works best in all of my setups, Glock and Colt. Does not have extraction issues as long as all of the parts are in place. As I found out with the Kaw Valley Precision one, I had received a bolt that actually was missing the post from the inside of the spring, and that caused extraction issues, but once actually caused ejection issues because there wasn't enough tension on the extractor. So Kaw Valley Precision, good on them, sent me a whole brand new bolt, and it's been working fine. I did check it. It does have all the parts. It has the spring, post, and O-ring, and works fine. And no issues with any of these. By far the most expensive is the Brownells Hybrid. By the way, Brownells Glock only bolt has really bad reviews. This is the Hybrid, which means it'll work with both Colt and Glock. This one was the most expensive. I have two of these, and they run fantastic. I have the Kaw Valley Precision, of course, and this is basically identical. It's a bit less expensive, good company, and I like those bolts as well. And then the least expensive of them is the BK Firearms. This one is, for all intents and purposes, all three of these appear to be identical and probably made by the same original equipment manufacturer supplier or OEM supplier. And they all run fantastic. So if I were to get another bolt, based on what I've seen with all of these types of bolts, it would either be the Brownells or Kaw Valley Precision or BK Firearms style. I have two of the BK Firearms that have been working fine. No issues at all with them in Colt or Glock setups. And like I said, they seem to be the least expensive ones. And right now, that's the one I would go for if I needed another bolt. So there's a close-up of the bolt faces and a little bit of information about them. Oh, and I forgot to mention that all of these bolts are one-piece bolts, which means that they are made of one piece of steel and have a extra weight added into the hollow rear of the bolt held in by a roll pin. Now, the FM9 bolt takes a different size roll pin and has a different size weight and different size hole as a result going through it, so that makes it a little unusual. All the rest take a standard sized weight, which is usually 2.2 ounces in these. The TACCOM has a set screw that actually holds it in place, which makes it easier to remove. And if you're going to go with a law tactical folder or something like that, where a insert plug needs to be put into the rear of the bolt, this is the kind that you would use. Other types have essentially a shortened bolt and a weight that's been plugged into the rear and is full diameter, but if you remove it, it shortens the entire bolt. So this whole section comes out as well as an insert as part of the weight. That's the other type of bolt design that's out there, and those are not necessarily compatible with any kind of a folding mechanism. And some of them, because, and unfortunately I don't have one of those bolts here, but because of the way that the hole is cut, there's a very thin area right next to the pinhole, which may crack, and I've seen reports of that as well, which is why I don't like those bolts that are what I call two-piece, or a shortened bolt with a large plug onto the back of or the rear extending the length of the bolt. So there you go. If I were to get another 9mm AR bolt, it would be the BK Firearms 9mm AR bolt. This one has all the characteristics and features that I like. It seems to work fantastic in both 9mm Glock as well as Colt style setups, and they're not very expensive at all. So That's my choice after going through all of these bolts and trying them in all different setups. Because of the price, primarily because it has the same contour, shape, features, and everything as other more expensive similar bolts, these are my choice for now. So there you have it. And that's all I've got for you today. So take care, and I'll see you in the next video.